Well, hey everybody, it's time to shave. I got a couple of things in the mail from Douglas over at Phoenix Shaving. First of all, look at this. Look at that thing, look at that creature. Baby Yoda? No. This is an alum block in something called the dry dock, and that's what this little thing is, this black spongy thing. It's a place to put it when you're done. See that? Normally, when I do my alum blocks, I kind of sit it on the edge of something so it doesn't make a mess. Well, look, it comes with one. I like that. And it's got a little rubber band alongside. I haven't unwrapped it yet, but it's got a rubber band, no slip grip system. It's just a rubber band. But thank you, Douglas, for sending that to me. Now I've got three alum blocks. That's going to last me a long time. And I hope I'm here to outlast those alum blocks. All right. But here's the exciting thing. Here's something that everyone was asking. Well, they weren't asking. They were like, you should get this. You should try this. And I was like, I don't know. The chill mill. This salt shaker looking thing is full of menthol crystals. Can you see them in there? Glistening like new fallen snow. The chill mill. Douglas, you've been watching, haven't you? You know I'm a menth head. That's right. I like my menth. Look at that Yeti's attacking this poor guy. Woo! Phoenix Shaving, Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements Shaving, chill mill. Here's what you do. It's like a salt shaker. In fact, we have one downstairs that is full of salt that looks exactly like this. So I'm going to show you how to use that. I haven't used it yet, so it's going to be the inaugural session here. All right, I took a shower, did my hair. I didn't take a bath or a shower yesterday, or shave, so I've been very lazy. It's the Christmas season. It's the quarantine season. It's been almost, what, 9, 10 months now we've all been cooped up. Every now and then you don't take a bath. Take a bath. At least twice a week, I would say. At least. For me, I got to do it almost every day. All right. So I'm going to take a non-mentholated. I thought about putting it in the margaritas in the Arctic, but I'm going to try one that's not mentholated. Taylor of Old Bond Street. I'm smelling the cap. Did you notice that? Oh, smells. Oh, there we go. So I've been using this. It's pretty good stuff. Almond scented. I love it. And I'm going to use the Rockwell because I'm sick of using Fat Boys for right now. And somebody said, hey, I haven't seen the Captain's Choice Nor'easter in a while. So we're going to Dracar Noir scent shave balm, mentholate myself at the end. Did that make sense? Hopefully. So here's what you do with this. Now, it's got a little cap that you can take off and you can, like, sprinkle over your, you know, spaghetti if you want. Don't, because this is menthol crystals. And so what it says on the bottle is to do it, grind it twice. Do... Let's call that one. And then two. And then can you see how they're now in the bottom there? I'm going to do it two more. Oh, now there's a whole little pile. See that? Now, this is silly. I shouldn't do this. But I'm going to upend it. Make sure all the crystals are off the little cap. Watch this. Oh, I was hoping it was going to pop or something. So now I got all the little crystals down there. And I'm going to sprinkle them in here like pixie dust. Ready? Just do it in there, get it all in. It just keeps coming out. And then it says leave it there for like 20 seconds. So I'm not gonna take that long, I don't think. I'm just gonna put the top back on the old chill mill. Have you ever heard of an old actor named Chill Wills? It's named after him. I'm only kidding. All right, I'm gonna put some hot water on my cold face. And I got a couple of shout outs. First of all, George Spivey. Shout out to you, George. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing right now, here's your shout out. All right, let's do this. Let's lather up. Let's lather it up and get on. I'm trying to get all the edges, get all the menthol I can without getting too much. We'll see. Oh, almond scent and menthol. Let's see if it's a good combination or not. If it's not, that's all right. At least we tried. So yeah, if you've, like, I don't know when it was, a year ago, year and a half, I don't even know. I've lost track of time. I bought some menthol crystals and ground them up and, like, or crushed them up and put them in stuff. But this is way easier if you're, like, a stupid idiot like I am. I didn't want to do that. All right. There we go. Perfect. Look at that. Yeah, perfect. Got a feather blade in here. Ooh, it's cold, man. I was wintertime now. I notice how cold the razor is. Put it in some hot water. Let it sit in your sink before you stick it up on your face. Unless you want to wake up in the morning. Better than a hot cup of coffee. I got a little bit of that soap and menthol in my mouth. Not too bad. Not too bad. Just a little soapy. I think I should have done a few more grinds of that stuff. I might grind it directly onto the brush itself. Because like I said, I'm an idiot. Don't do that if you got sensitive skin, because it will probably irritate you. These pure menthol crystals. It's just pure essence of the mint plant. They've got a couple of them I learned. Mentha pepperita, right? I believe it's called. And then a different one that's cheaper. I can't remember where that's from. But if you want the traditional, true, kind of a little bit better quality, look for the mentha pepperita in flavored things like Altoids or whatever. All right. Shaving as usual. Because it's the old Rockwell. I haven't shaved in a little while. I've been shaving with the fat guy. It's been doing a dang good job. I really enjoy that razor. I'm not as keen on the build quality. It could use some tweaking. But as a razor shaving, man, it shaves fantastically. All right. Here we go. All right, second pass. And second shout out to Andrew. It's your birthday coming up, Andrew. Probably get YouTube to take the video down because of that. All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put this down the counter and I'm going to grind some more menthol onto it. I'm going to put it in the sink so it doesn't get everywhere. I'm going to take the top off. I'm going to do it from here. I'm going to be like Salt Bay. Is that still a meme? Menth Bay. Ready? Kids? Millennials? You know what I'm talking about. All right, here we go. All right, directly on. And my arm. It's all over my arm. Look at that. It's all over my arm. Oh, God. This is a mistake. This is a terrible, terrible mistake. What have I done? All right, I'm going to take this stuff off the bottom and kind of let the crystals kind of decrystallize, liquefy. I don't know. Will they? I don't know. Ooh, oh. Yeah, they do. They just kind of dissolve in water. There was one right there in a little puddle of water. So if you give it a few seconds, it'll actually dissolve and not be crunchy on your face. Don't talk when you're lathering, folks, like I just did. Mmm. Mmm. I'm feeling a little bit more menthol with that one. I think the direct. I don't think I put enough the first time, at least for my taste. And I'm an idiot, so what do I know? You hear that? Taking it down. Ooh, yeah, I'm definitely feeling the menthol now. But it's not so much that it's making me cry. Not so much as it makes me cry. Hmm, interesting. Definitely feeling it. But it's good. It's a nice little tingle. You know, I didn't look up the price. I apologize. I'll put links below to both the alum block thingy and the chill wills, the chill mill. And you can check the price. What, now I gotta do my homework for you people? Now I gotta do research for this channel? I'm kind of a lazy guy. I try to fight that. It's been one of those things I dislike about my own character and personality. Procrastination and a little bit of laziness. But I do like to get things done because it feels so good. I go out and rake leaves and then you've done it. Or you take care of those bills that you've been putting off and then you've done it and you feel so good. But at the same time, if you took care of everything exactly on time when it was supposed to be done, then you wouldn't have that feeling of, oh, thank God that's done. I don't know. Is that valid? You be the judge. All right. Third pass, normal this time. No more grinding. I know that's what you come to this channel for, is Watch me grind. God. Yay. This is just disturbing. All right. Ooh, still plenty of menthol in there. Mmm. My arm doesn't feel tingly, so that's good. That's good. Could be the sign of a medical condition if it does. All right, I always like to go at an angle and up just to get this because my neck is always tough. And I know for a lot of you, it's the same way. It's like it's a coarser hair down there and then it seems to grow in all different kind of directions. So, but if you do it enough, you'll get the hang of it, I think. But that's just my opinion. I could be wrong. Christmas is only a week and a day away. It's exciting. It's a beautiful time of year. The sunlight is gorgeous outside right now. It's a beautiful sunny day. The Northeast had a ton of snow yesterday. But of course, we didn't. One of these days, I'm gonna go up and like into the mountains of Colorado where there's like 6 feet of snow all the time. And I'm gonna get somebody to rent a cabin and pay for it. Because who do I look like? Duck McScrooge, is that his name? Scrooge McDuck, that's his name. I don't know. Mr. Moneybags. Anyway, yeah, snow. I just want to be around a ton of snow. I've never experienced that. Like, just a ton. I don't want to live there. I just want to visit. The new fallen snow, mind you. Not the, the four-month-old snow that's turned into slush and brown and gross. I've seen that. Still kind of fun, though, because you can, you know, where the snow plows have gone. You can break through the crust and get to that white snow underneath. Now I sound like Tony Montana, for God's sake. I don't know what's going on today. Must be the chill mill. Thank you, Douglas. You finally put me over the edge. Mentally. All right. What do we got? Got stuff? Got the normal? There we go. Got to know when to stop. And that should probably go for all things in life. Know when to stop. Know when to say when. You'll thank yourself later. The version of you tomorrow morning will thank yourself. Oh, say yeah, that was good. You know, it's funny. Putting that extra menthol completely masked the smell of the almond, which is kind of a more subtle, soft scent. Not bold, so all it smells like now is just like mint, so which is good for me. I like it. So I'm gonna put this back on, close it up, wash off the outside, clean everything up. Oh, I gotta put aftershave, Captain's Choice Nor'easter, smells like Drakkar Noir, feels like 6 feet of snow. That's crazy how much it smells like Drakkar Noir. And if you've never smelled Drakkar Noir, well, walk behind me. No, I don't wear it that often anymore. There we go. I think that's it. So, George, Andrew, happy birthday, Andrew. Thank you, Douglas, over at Phoenix Shaving for this. This was fun. This is good. I like this. I'm gonna put this in the kitchen cabinet and see if they accidentally put this on a baked potato. No, I'm not gonna do that. Jeez, that would not be good. All right, I think that's it. Thanks, everybody. Hope you have a great weekend. Coming up, Christmas week. I know. Monday and then Friday. Friday's Christmas. I will be putting out a video on Christmas. I might even have a little Christmas live video. You know, I'm sitting on the porch drinking some eggnog or something. I don't know. Something fun, right? Right? Okay. Well, everybody, have a great one. I'll see you soon.